Very good morning, students. Welcome back to first year physics. So in the previous class, actually, we discussed about a related to variation of pressure with a depth is over, and as well as pressure density also finished. Now let I want to say about a atmospheric pressure and barometer. See, thing is, atmospheric pressure is nothing but, see, in all open areas, there is a pressure is act, is to be same for all bodies. The pressure is act. And one more point I want to say. See, this atmosphere, that mean here, this air and other air particles and other dust particles and other gas particles, see, it is to be located to a height above the earth surface is approximately 200 kilometers. See, after 200 kilometers, there is no pressure, there is no air and dust and everything, but it is above the earth surface approximately it is 200 kilometers only. See, after that there will be nothing is there, it is in a vacuum, or we can call empty. Now here, so we need to find a atmospheric pressure by using a barometer experiment. Sir, what is barometer? Barometer is nothing but it is consist of a one inverted U tube. See, in that tube, if the tube is equal to 100 centimeter, the height of the tube is 100 centimeter, or we can say it is a 1 meter. So that tube is filled with a mercury, completely filled with a mercury without any air bubbles. And your other end you close with a thumb, and the tube is inverted, or it is to be inserted in a beaker, the beaker containing a mercury. So that here I'll show you the diagram. The barometer is an instrument which used to measure the atmospheric pressure. It is in a beaker. So the beaker is contains a mercury, and here there is a tube. The tube is, it is a U tube, like you say, clear, and it is a 1 meter we can call, or it is 100 centimeter. So this is completely filled with the mercury. Now this open end is closed with a thumb, and that is inserted, or it is into the mercury containing a beaker, so that the tube is placed inside like this, or it is to be inverted like this. Then there will be a like this. So some mercury falls down into the beaker. So the mercury, its convex is upward will shows, and here also this shows some convex is like this. So this we can say it is about what it is, we can say like a mercury inside it is, there is a completely empty, there is no air particle, because the liquid or the mercury falls, and the level of the liquid in the mercury or in the U tube is, we can say, H. That H is equal to approximately 76 centimeter. That is the height of the mercury in this tube, approximately we can say 76 centimeter of Hg. This is we can call. The mercury falls down into the beaker containing a mercury. Now let us, we need to find a atmospheric pressure, ATM. So let us, I want to say, there it is, you look at here, there will be an open areas, right? So this is an open, so that there will be a pressure is acting, here also there will be a pressure is acting on the mercury column. So at this point, you give a one A, and this is you say B, and this is you say something point. Right, let us use some D point. So there is a pressure is acting at this point, therefore the pressure is distributed equally in all directions according to the Pascal's law, because the liquid is at an a static, so that the pressure acting, this is an atmospheric pressure is acting P naught, and which is to be distributed overall throughout the complete mercury. And at this point also this levels are same, no, therefore here whatever the pressure is acting at a point A, and at a point D also act same, and at a point B also act same, because of the level or same, the height of the levels are same. Not only that, at this point also act same, but here at above this there is no pressure is acting, so that here you say some pressure is something, you take a PC, and here it is an open area, no, therefore it is an a closed area, no, so that at a closed area there will be no pressure is acting, because there is no air particle, but there is a pressure is acting at this point P naught, and it is also acting a PA. At this point is a PD and at this point is PB. This all pressures are equal because it is equally distributed. Now let us you write a difference in pressure. That is, we can say here you say PD or it is PB or it is PA, all equal, no? So that you write a PA minus PC is equal to H rho g because the difference in height. We know difference in pressure. So that your PA is equal to, you write as PC plus H rho g. Inside the tube, actually there is a pressure is zero. So that you say PC is zero. PA is equal to H rho g. This is the pressure of the liquid or the pressure of the mercury column. It is H is nothing but a, you say 76 centimeter of Hg. Here you write H is equal to 76 centimeter of Hg, or you want to write in meter, so that 0.76 meter of Hg. And here a density we know, mercury is 13.6 kg per meter cube, and we know g value is 9.8 meter per second square. These are the values related to determine the pressure of a given at a place of a atmosphere. So let us substitute this all values here. That is the pressure of at that point or atmospheric pressure, you say P naught, because which is acting P naught, no? We can also write a PA is equal to P naught. So P naught is equal to 0.76 meter of Hg into 13.6 into it is, we can write as the 9.8. So that here we'll get, after simplify, we may get the approximately 1.013 into 10 to the power 5, right? It is what it is, we can say Pascal. So that atmospheric pressure is nothing but a, or it is atm. 1 atm is equal to 1.013 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal it is. So this is the atmospheric pressure is acting at an open areas. That's what we can call, it is an open areas, there will be an atmospheric pressure is acting. So the given a places. So this is an a barometer and a device, the device which use it to measure the atmospheric pressure. Clear? Now come to the point. So there will be another is there. That is, one more instrument is there, so that we can say manometer. So what is manometer? So the manometer also device. Here you say manometer. So manometer is a device, the device which used to measure the pressure of any given a gas, the pressure of any given a gas, that's what we can call manometer. So the manometer is consist of a one glass bulb, which is to be evacuated glass bulb, like it is in a completely evacuated, and it is to be connected one now horizontal tube, and this tube is connected to another U tube. That is, we can say like the tube will be like, this is we can call as the U tube. Clear? So this is just an empty tube, right? Now let us, I want to calculate of a given gas pressure. So that you do one thing, from this open area, let us you take, or you, it is a, you take a one, any one liquid, like not only mercury, you take any liquid. Suppose from this open area, if the liquid is taken into the tube, so that in this actually there will be some gas, or it is to be trapped in some air, or it is inside some gas is there, no? So gas is filled this certain level, therefore you take a some liquid to the certain levels, like till a certain levels like this, so that here inside it is, there will be a gas or there will be some air particles are inside, it is to be like this, right? This is will be to be completely trapped inside the open pipe like it is, so that this air or gas particles which are acting or which are the force is applied on the given a liquid, or the liquid is taken to the tube, no? So that you say it is a A point, and here you say same point, no? See, this pressure will be same. You remember this, both pressure will be same. This is a A and B, and you take a C. Again, here very simple. See, through this open area, there will be an atmospheric pressure is acting, of course, P naught is acting on the liquid. So this pressure is distributed equally in all, because there will be some liquid is taken, no? See, it's not like a mercury, you can take any liquid, so which is to be filled like this. So there will be a pressure is distributed, because the pressure is acting here, that is to be act here also same, and the levels are same, no? There will be a pressure also same, it is act. That pressure is, we can say, atmospheric pressure is distributed equally in all direction. So that's what we can say, pressure at a point A is equal to pressure at a point B. We can also write like this. See, there is a one we can take, pressure at point A is equal to pressure at point B is same, because both levels are same, no? Therefore this liquid also applies the pressure on the gas, that is also same, because which are at the gas molecules are contact with the liquid, no? So that there will be a pressures are acting is same. So that you say there will be a pressure is PA is equal to PB is equal to, we can say atmospheric pressure is acting, no? So that atmospheric pressure is, you say, it is a P naught is acting plus. See, there will be a height of the liquid between B and C, you say H. So that we can take as here H rho G, because height due to the pressure is acting, height due to, that is the liquid height is H, so that liquid height also applies the pressure, that is we can say H rho G. Now here we know PA is equal to PB is equal to P naught plus H rho G, this is the actually pressure is acting, and here we can also take as PA is equal to P naught plus R minus H rho G. Sir, what is this P naught plus R minus H G? And here from here we can also take PA minus P naught is equal to H rho G also we can. So this PA minus P naught is nothing but a difference in pressure. So difference in pressure is nothing but a, we can call as the excess pressure. We can call excess pressure. That excess also we can call as the gauge pressure. Gauge pressure we can call GAUGES, gauge pressure. So that this manometer can calculate the gauge pressure also, that is we can say difference in pressure, because there will be a difference in pressure is there. The difference in pressure is nothing but we can call as the gauge or excess pressure. So that here we can also write here PA is equal to P naught plus R minus H rho G. Sir, when will be plus, when will be minus? Very simple, if the liquid level is if it is liquid level is below the A, right? If below the A, you remember here, if it is below A, you say as it is to be, we can say the liquid level is below A, so that it is, we can take it as negative, and if it is above this, we can take it as positive. That's what it is. So level of the liquid in the both the this limbs, see, if the level of the liquid above A, above A in a given limb, so that you say PA is equal to P naught plus H rho G, right? It is one. And come to the point, if the level of the liquid it is below, you say below the A, that's what we can say, it is, we can take it as negative. So this is about a manometer. So that the manometer is a device, the device which used to measure the pressure of a given any gas. So this is the related theory and related concept of given a manometer, right? And we are coming to the point, on this basis, in general, in a given a uniform fluid, I want to say, like, in a given a uniform fluid, there will be some important information is there. See, in a given a uniform fluid, or the fluid is at rest, that mean your uniform fluid, and it is to be located at some heights. So for that uniform fluid, see that you remember your uniform fluid pressure is depends on, see, based on the manometer or barometer, see, we can say like this, it is depends on, see, pressure depends on first one. So the thing is, we can say atmospheric pressure ATM, that is P naught. First it is depends on ATM, that we can call atmospheric pressure, it is depends. Second we can say depth of the liquid, right? That is, we can say depth also it is depends, because we know P is equal to P naught plus H rho g, no? This is the pressure is depends on atmospheric pressure, and H or depth it is, and also depends on density. So you said density rho, and also depend on acceleration due to gravity at a given a place, because H rho g. P naught is nothing but we can call atmospheric pressure, and H is nothing but a depth, and rho is nothing but a density, and g is nothing but acceleration due to gravity. But it is independent. It is independent on, is there any mass? There is no mass in an expression. So it is independent on mass, and it is also independent on shape and size. Shape and size of the container or tubes. That's what we can say. It is like this, pressure depends on this basis. So that it is also independent on mass, or we can say amount of liquid, no? And I'll tell you, in a static fluid there will be a one question, like you take a different types of a container. If I take a one container like this, see, in this container some liquid is taken. See, height of the liquid is h. This is the one shape. You take one more tube, which height of the liquid should be same, remember, but the amount of liquid is different. But see the two containers which are in a different shapes, right? So I want to show one more also. Let us see, this is one more. See, height of the liquids are same. If heights are same but amount of liquids are different, look at, thing is like this. So all are open areas, no? Here it is the pressure is depends actually depth, but height is same. And here amount of liquid is different, look at, amount of liquid is different. Therefore the pressure is acting for all these situations remains the same. Pressure remains constant because it is independent on mass and shape of the containers. Shape or a size, independent on mass or amount of liquid or shape and size. That's what we can call. Here the pressure remains constant because it does not depend on the amount of liquids and shape of the containers. That's what I mean to say. This is the one issue. And coming to the one more issue, I want to say about a paradox. Sir, what is paradox? It is actually for 2 marks question in IPE. So regularly they are asking, there is a paradox. You say it is paradox. Paradox is nothing but if a different shape of containers, different size of a containers are connected, it is to be like this. You take, see, in a uniform fluid, let us one container is to be connected, and here another shape of container, you take like this. And there will be a one more container is connected. Here I am telling you, you take any type of shape, any shape, like, see, this is will be the shapes are different. See, which is to be connected like this. So height of the liquids are same. This you keep in your mind. Height must be same. So whatever the amount of liquid you are taking into the tubes, that must be same. See, you remember this, each and every shape of a container, the liquid is connected with one another, right? Because this liquid is connected with this liquid. That mean here this point A, this point B, and you say this point C, and it is D. So this all points are, it is contact with the one another. So this all are connected, or it is all, or it is contact with one another. So this one is connected with this one, and it is connected because the liquid is flowing from one tube to another tube, like. But height of the liquids are same. This is very very important. You take like this. So this height is h, this is also height is h, and it is also height is h. This is, you say, ha, hb, hc, and in this the liquid, whatever you are taking, liquid, water or something, so that the level of the liquids are same. This is, you say, hd. And you remember HA is equal to HB is equal to HC is equal to HD, because hall heights, container A, container B, container C, container D, different shapes are there. And here at a bottom points, the pressure of in a given all containers, in a given all containers, the pressure is PA is equal to PB is equal to PC is equal to PD is constant. That means here remains at rest, no? The liquid is remains at rest and all liquid molecules are contact with one another. So that the pressure is acting for all areas inside the tubes are same, because this all are open areas, no? So that the pressure is distributed equally in all. And at the bottom of the container, the pressure is acting is same. This phenomena we can call as the paradox. You take a different shapes, not like this, you take in a different another way, another manner also, you can proceed it, no problem, because the pressure must be same at all points, which molecules are connected with one another. So this phenomena we can call as the paradox. This question was given in the year of 2019 in our IP examination. So which is very important, everyone, you keep in your minds, which is very important. So this is the concept related to paradox and static fluids. So this is about a what related to the today's topic, right? And here we'll continue in the next class. So, thank you very much. We'll see you in the next class.